Hello everyone. Now question number 7. Question 7 is, find the equation of the line drawn perpendicular to this line through the point where it meets the y-axis. So we have to find out the equation of this line. This line, we have to find out the equation which meets this line, this line at y-axis. Perpendicular at y-axis. So we will take that this its coordinates as 0 and y and solve this equation of the line. This equation of the line, so you will get 6x plus 4y minus 24 equals 0. And since it is the line whose equation you have to find out, it is perpendicular to the given line. So first we will find out the slope of this line. So slope you will get it, slope of this line you will get it as minus a upon b, so minus a upon 4, 6 upon 4, so it will come as minus 3 by 2. Now, what should be the slope of the line now? Slope of line, whose equation we have to find out, that is 2 by 3, since m1, m2 equal minus 1. Okay, now the further question is that this 0 and y is satisfying this equation also. Since this 0 y is passing through this line also. So 0 y here, 0 y satisfy equation 6x plus 4y minus 24 equals 0. Okay. So, we will put this value 0y over here. So, it will come as 4y minus 24 equals 0. And here we will get y as 6. So, the coordinate of this will be 0 and 6. So, the coordinates of given line, one coordinate of line will be 0 and 6. So one point is given and its slope is also given. So can we make the equation of the line? Yes, by using the one point formula we can make it. So equation of line is y minus y1 equal m. Slope is 2 by 3. X minus x1. Now solve it further. So 3y minus 18 equal 2x. Or we can say 2x minus 3y plus 18 equal 0. So this is the equation of line. Okay. Come to question 8. In question 8, it is written, find the area of triangle formed by the lines this. Area of the triangle formed by the line this. So, we will consider the line equation as, in this case, in the triangle, we will consider it as the equation of line. Ab aapko area of triangle nikalna hai. So, to find out the area of triangle, what you have to find out? You have to find out the coordinates. So, how will you find out the coordinates? So, first you will take it equation 1, 2 and 3. So, solve these two equations to get the coordinate of B. Same way, by taking these two, you will get the coordinate of A. And by these two, you will get the coordinate of C. So, after getting the coordinates of triangle ABC, can you find out the area of the triangle? Its formula, we have done it in our 10th class to find out the area of the triangle. So, same formula you will apply to get the answer. I think you can be able to do it. Okay. Question 9. In question 9, it is written, find the value of P such that these three lines may intersect at one point. D these three lines means it intersect at one point. It means the point of intersection of these three lines should be same. And then you have to find out the value of P. So to get the answer of P, so what will you do? You will solve equation 1 and 3 first to get the value of x and y. That value you will put it in 2 to get the answer of P. So what will you do? You will solve equation 1 and 3. Why we are solving 1 and 3? Because there is no variable like this. P is not written. Or some unknown variable is not written. So by taking these two equations, we can find out the value of x and y. So solve equation 1 and 2. So from here, you will get x value and y value. Some value you will get it. And that x and y value, you will put it in equation 2. So then you will put value of x and y in equation 2, okay, to get the value of P. So after putting the value in equation 2, you will get the value of P by solving it. I think you can do it. Now come to the next question. In question 10, it is given that if these three lines are concurrent, then show that this. Concurrent means if all the lines passing through the one point, or we can say the point of intersection of the all the lines are same. So there is one way to solve it. First take these two equations to get the value of x and y. Whatever value you will get it, substitute that value in equation 3. And then you can solve it further to get the answer. So this is the one way. But this way is little bit lengthy. And the shortcut way to do this question is related to your 12th class. We will do that method. Otherwise you can do it by solving these two to get the value of x and y. And that x, y you will solve, put it in equation 3 to get the answer. And then you will get this answer. You have to rearrange the terms to get the answer. So this is the one way. But we will take one method which is there in your 12th standard. So you will shift all the terms on one side. So m1x minus y plus c equals 0. This is one equation. m2x minus y plus c2 equals 0. And m3x plus minus y plus C3 equals 0. Now, the next step to write the coefficients of x, y and all the constant terms. So, m1, m2, m3 and here it will be minus 1, minus 1, minus 1 and it will become C1, C2 and C3. This concept is there in your 10th class to find out the value of x and y by cross multiplication method also. So same method is there in your 10th class also. So what we will do, you have to find out this. So first we will take m1. Ab agar aapne m1 liya, so you will hide this line m1 और ये line आप hide कर देंगे. This you will hide it. This and this. Okay? And then you will cross multiply it. Means this multiply this minus of this multiply this. If you will hide it like this, so only the part will be this. ये आपके पास रह जाएगा. So you will multiply like this. This multiply this minus of this multiply this. So you will take m1, this m1, now in bracket, this multiply this, ye order mein aapko jana hai, pehle aise. So this multiply this, so minus c3 and minus of this multiply this. then you have to do it in this way. So it will be minus, or minus will become plus. Okay, is it clear? Now this is positive. Now you will put the negative sign. Negative of m2. एक बार प्लस फिर माइनस m2. नाउ सेम वे यू विल हाइलाइट m2 के साथ जो नंबर्स आ रहे हैं दैट यू विल हाइलाइट. इट मींस यू विल हाइड, नाउ यू विल हाइड दिस, ये m2 के साथ और एक ये. सो द लेफ्ट आउट इज दिस मल्टीप्लाई दिस एंड दिस मल्टीप्लाई दिस. इज इट क्लियर? So minus of m2, this multiply this. So you will go it in this way and then you will go in this way. So it will become minus c3 minus of this multiply this. So it will become plus c1. Now plus minus, now plus. It's elaborate way you will do it in your 12th class. Now m3. To get m3, now you will, let's see what we have to hide it. m3, ye aap hide karenge and this you will hide it. This and this. This you will hide it. So what will be the step now? You will multiply this first and then you will multiply minus of this. So m3, this into this. So it will come as minus c2 minus of this multiply this. So minus minus will become plus and this whole equals to zero. Now look at the portion which we have to prove it. This is the easiest way to do it. You can rewrite it like this, rearrange the term. So minus minus will become plus m2. So it will become c3 minus c1, m3, then c1 minus c2. So easiest way to do it, or you can apply the point of intersection concept also as I have explained it just now. Okay. Question 11. In question 11 it is written, find the equation of the line passing through point 32 and which makes an angle 45 degree with the line this. 45 degree with the line this. So one point is given. So let the slope of that line whose equation we have to find it is m. So equation of line will be y minus y1 equal m x minus x1. And this is one of the line. Its slope is, if you will find out the slope, it will be minus half. You know it formula jisme aapka degree diya ho aur two slopes diye hain. So how will you, what formula you will apply? In that you will apply the formula tan theta equal m1 minus m2 upon 1 plus m1 m2 mod. So same formula we will apply. This is, you will take m1 tan theta equal m2 minus m1. So this you will take it as m2 and this is m1 m2 minus m1 upon 1 plus m1 m2. Apply the formula in this tan 45 1. Now remove the mod sign. You will get it plus minus. And after taking plus 1 first, you will get one value and then take minus 1, you will get another value. Now, the question is that you have to make the equation of the line. Equation banani hai. So, what will you do? This is the equation of the line. Ab aap kya karenge? First, you will put m equal 3 in this to get one equation and then you will take m equal minus 1 by 3 to get one more equation. So, first, in this equation 1, put the value, therefore y minus 2 equal 3, x minus 3, okay. So from here, you will get y minus 2 equal 3x minus 9 or 3x minus y minus 7 equal 0. So this is one of the equations. Similarly, you can find out for, this is for m equal 3. Similarly, you can find out for m equal minus 1 by 3. Okay, to get it for minus 1 by 3, so it will be y minus, same equation. Now, Now you will take minus 1 by 3, x minus 3. Now solve it. So you will get 3y minus 6 equal minus x plus 3. This you will get it. Now shift the term. So x plus 3y minus 9 equal 0. So this is the another equation. So you will get these two equations of line here. I hope this question is clear to all of you. Question 12. In question 12, it is written, the question is, find the equation of line passing through the intersection of these two has equal intercept on the axis. Equal intercept on the axis. So, passing through the intersection of these two. So, if you will solve it, you will get these point of intersection x and y. Okay, has equal intercept on the axis. So what should be the intercept form? That is x upon a plus y upon b. So instead of b, since it is equal intercept, you will take it a equal 1. Ab aap kya karenge? You will substitute these two values. Put x equal 1 by 13 and y equal 5 by 13 in equation 1. After putting the value in equation 1, you will get to get value of a. A ki value aa jayegi. And then after getting the value of a, then you will put the value of a in equation 1 again to get the equation of line. I hope that this part is clear. Aap kya karenge? Put x and y value in this equation. X and y value. And after putting it, aapke paas a ki value aa jayegi. And after getting the a value, since you have to find out the equation of the line, this is the equation of the line intercept on the axis. So, a value you will get it and here you will put it to get the equation of line. I hope that this question is clear to all of you. That's all for today. Thank you and have a nice day.